Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Guys, we are going through al-Fawz al-Kabir. This is a version which is translated by my beloved teacher, Sheikh Muhammad Anwar al-Badakhshani. You probably come across some of his other books as well that he has. This is one of them, which is translation from Persian to Arabic. Anyway, my name is Liaquat Zaman and we are going through this now. So if you remember last time, we talked about the issue with regards to the mushrikeen. Okay, so we said regarding the mushrikeen, all right, so the mushrikeen basically of Mecca, their origins are supposed to be from Ibrahim alayhi salam, right? So like Ibrahim alayhi salam origins, so Ibrahim alayhi salam's teachings that he taught to do Hajj and face the Qibla and wash yourself and etc., all these things, they seem to be found within the Arab tradition, but they've been distorted a lot, right? So anyway, so last time, if you remember, we talked about those. Now we're going to be talking about something else now. So he says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Bayanu shubahat al-mushrikeen fil aqaid al-islamiyya. So this is the explanation of the shubahat, of the doubts that the mushrikeen have regarding Islamic beliefs. أما جمهور المشركين, as for the majority of the مشركين, فكان لهم شبهات واعتراضات كثيرة. They had شبهات, اعتراضات, شبهات means confusions, doubts, اعتراضات, they had questions which they raised against, اعتراض, كثيرة حول تلك الأقائد regarding all these beliefs. وكان شبهاتهم ناشئة. And their beliefs stemmed from these three things. Imma min istib'adi hadhi al-umur. The mushriks either believed that these things that Islam teaches were far-fetched, istib'ad. Wa imma min adam al-ulfati biha. Or that they were not familiar with it. Adam al-ulfa, not being familiar with it. Or number three, wa imma min adami idrakiha. Or that they had not understood them. Right, they had not adam idrak. So these are the three main reasons where they have the main i'tiradat against Islam. وَكَانَ أَسْبَابُ ضَلَالَتِهِمْ مَا يَأْتِي. And the reasons for their deviance, because remember, they were on the straight path once, but they became deviated. مَا يَأْتِي. Number one, الْإِشْرَاكُ بِاللَّهِ. They were making partners with Allah. وَتَشْبِيهُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى بِأَحَدٍ مِنْ خَلْقِهِ. And they were personifying Allah. They were giving Allah features of one of his creations, like giving him physical features that were resembling creation. Number three, تحريف ملة إبراهيم. They were distorting the teachings, the ways of Ibrahim. Number four, وإنكار المعاد. Rejection of the resurrection, المعاد, the life of the hereafter, الحياة الأخروية. Number five, واستبعاد رسالة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The far-fetchedness of the messenger of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشيوع الأعمال القبيحة. And the widespread of evil actions and مظالم and oppressions فيما بينهم amongst themselves. Number seven, وابتداع and innovations of مراسم الفاسدة, corrupt trends or rituals or culture. Number eight, finally, ترك الإبادات, leaving إبادات واندراس آثارها, and disappearing of their traces وجعلها نسيا منسيا, and making them forgotten. So basically, if you kind of think about this, if we were to kind of, let's take, for example, a verse of the Quran, for instance, right? Well, actually, we look in the Quran in a bit. Let's first of all look at what kind of teachings Ibrahim alayhi salam left behind. So, for example, Hajju Baytillah, Istiqbal al-Qibla, Ghusl Janaba, Ikhtitan, circumcision, those fitra, issues of fitra. Believing that certain things were haram in certain months of the year, honoring the house of Allah, the Kaaba, tahreem muharramat, all these kind of things. Some of these things they didn't, but a lot of these things they began to distort a lot of these things. And so we can actually say that the reasons why they had questions against Islam was, first of all, they thought that certain things in Islam were far-fetched, like how can this happen, and or they were not familiar with certain things, so they denied them, or they just couldn't understand them. So these eight things, you can imagine these eight things stemming from these three things. So for example, like them doing shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? So this is maybe something which they couldn't understand. They didn't understand about the importance of Tawheed. So they developed a shirk system. Tashbihullahi ta'ala, they began to make Allah resemble one of his creations. Again, this is something which was Adam Idraq. Tahrif Millat Ibrahim, they began to distort the teachings of Ibrahim. Could have also been Adam Idraq or Ulfa. Inkar al-Ma'ad, rejecting the hereafter, this is something which they found far-fetched. How can Allah bring someone back to life? Istib'ad, Risalat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, again, the same thing, that it's too hard to believe that Allah would send a human being to convey his message. Shuyu' al-A'mal al-Qabiha is spreading of evil actions. Right, so this is again, not understanding the importance of keeping in line with what Allah has sent down. Ibtida, and innovation of corrupt trends and ideas in society. Right, this may be something which is might be to do with istib'ad, might do Adam and Ulfa, could be one of these. Watarkul ibadat, and leaving ibadat. Right, this is something again, because they didn't see in their society, they stopped practicing these things, and slowly this is what tends to happen. So, in other words, Shah Waliullah rahimahullah, he's kind of like giving us an understanding of how these things slowly begin to manifest in society. Why is it that a beautiful religion, teachings of Ibrahim alayhi salam, can become something ugly like what the mushrikeen were basically doing? So if we try to have a look at, for example, something in the Quran. Okay, so some of the ayats to do with shirk, a lot of them you'll find in Surah An'am. So Surah An'am is one of those important surahs where you can see a lot of the shirk that these guys were getting up to, and you know how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to this. So let's have a look. So وَلَقَدْ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. First thing over here is وَقَالُوا, they said, وَقَالُوا, right? لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ مَلَكٌ. Why didn't Allah send an angel? Right? Why didn't Allah send an angel? Again, why are they? Because they're doing istib'ad of Risalat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's what Shaul is saying. This is an example of istib'ad of Risalat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are asking, like, Allah, this is i'tirad. Why didn't you send an angel, Allah? Why did you send a human? This doesn't make sense to us. And then Allah responds, لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا مَلَكًا لَقُضِيَ الْأَمْرِ. And if you were to send an angel, angels usually come to decide the matters on earth and you know, destruction. وَلَوْ جَعَلْنَاهُ مَلَكًا. And if, for argument's sake, we were to make the messenger an angel, لَجَعَلْنَاهُ رَجُلًا. We would have transformed him into a human. وَلَلَبَسْنَا عَلَيْهِ مَا يَلْبِسُونَ. And we would have covered upon him, or we would have labasa yalbisu, which means to confuse or to make something seem in a certain way, ma yalbisun, what they were confused in. In other words, the same question will arise again, that if we send an angel, the angel will have to come in the form of a human for you guys to be able to communicate with, and then you're going to have the same issue and the same question is going to arise again, right? Because you can't communicate with something which is out of your realm. وَلَقَدُ اسْتُهْزِيَ بِرُسُلٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ فَحَاقَ بِالَّذِينَ سَخِرُوا مِنْهُمْ. So Allah says, O Messenger of Allah, the people that came before mocked messengers before you. You know, so mocking of the messengers, again, is the same thing. Like we said, the istib'ad or risalat Muhammad and istib'ad of the prophets. This is like a common trait that you find amongst the people. Okay. قُلْ. So Allah says, say to the mushriks, لِمَمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To whom belongs everything in the skies and the earth? قُلْ لِلَّهِ. It belongs to Allah. Right? So in other words, again, this is something which you agree upon. Right? So this is something which they actually do agree upon. كَتَبَ عَلَى نَفْسِي لَيْجْمَعَنَّكُمْ. Alright. Let's go to the one. قُلْ أَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ أَتَّخِذُ وَلِيًا. This is in response to the shirk issue. So because they were doing shirk with Allah and they believed that there was other than Allah, so Allah says to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, قُلْ, say, أَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ, other than Allah, shall I take as one who will support me as an aid? You want me to go and worship someone besides Allah, who is the فاطر السماوات والأرض, the one who created the skies and the earth from nothing. وَهُوَ يُطْعِمُ وَلَا يُطْعَمُ. He is the one that feeds and is not fed. Right? So in other words, it makes sense, logically it makes sense why we need to worship Allah. So again, response to the shirk. قُلْ إِنِّي أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَوَّلَ مَنْ أَسْلَمْ. Okay. Let's go down. وَيَوْمَ نَحْشُرُهُمْ وَمَنْ أَظْلَمْ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. Allah says, who is more of an oppressor than the one who attributes lies to Allah, أو كَذَّبَ بِآيَاتِهِ, or denies his signs. So in other words, the mushriks. They attribute lies to Allah. They say Allah has sons, or Allah has children, or Allah is like this, or Allah is like that. You know, without any evidence or any proof at all. Or they deny Allah's signs. They deny the messengers, they deny the book, and so forth. Okay, so another thing over here. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَسْتَمِعُ إِلَيْكَ. Allah says, and from amongst the mushriks are those who listen carefully to what you say. وَجَعَلْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ أَكِنَّةً. And we've placed upon their hearts covers. And يَفْقَهُوهُ, for them to understand. So they don't understand the message. وَفِي أَذَانِهِمْ وَقْرٌ. And in their ears is a blockage. وَإِنْ يَرَوْ كُلَّ آيَةٍ. And if these people were to see every sign, لَا يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَا, they will not believe. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوكَ. So much so that they come to you, يُجَادِلُونَكَ, debating you. يَقُولُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Those who disbelieve say, إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. After listening to the Quran, what do they say? They say, this book is but أساطير الأولين, the stories of the people of the past. In other words, it's just made up fables. Right, so in other words, these people have no intention of understanding their religion. So Allah is just showing that this is something which Allah is blocking them from understanding because they don't want to understand. وَهُمْ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنْهُ وَيَنْعَوْنَ عَنْهُ. Okay, وَلَوْ تَرَى. Again, this is talking about the nature of how these people are debating. They are distorting the تحريف ملت إبراهيم, distorting the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam. They don't want to listen to the truth. And Ibrahim alayhi salam's way was to listen to the logical proofs. Okay. وَقَالُوا إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَبْعُوثِينَ. They said that إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا. This is not except, it is not except the life of this world, our life of this world. Yeah. So in other words, the hereafter will not come. So remember we said إِنْكَارُ الْمَعَادِ, they reject the hereafter. All right. So this is an example of that. وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَبْعُوثِينَ. استبعاد. Again, استبعاد. Al-Ba'ath, Al-Ma'ad. Okay, same thing over there again. قَدْ خَسِرَ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِلِقَاءِ اللَّهِ. Verily, lost are those, in loss are those who denied the meeting of Allah. Yeah, okay. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَعِبٌ لَحْمٌ قَدْ نَعْلَمٌ. So, وَلَقَدْ كُذِّبَتْ رُسُلٌ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ فَصَبَرُوا. Indeed, prophets, messengers that came before you were called liars. فَصَبَرُوا. And those messengers were patient. عَلَى مَا كُذِّبُوا. Against, on what these people were, or the lies that were being said, or the denial. وَأُوذُوا. And they were harmed. حَتَّى أَتَاهُمْ نَصْرُنَا. Until our help came to them. Okay. قَالُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ عَلَيْهِ آيَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِ. So they said, why isn't a verse from his Lord sent? So in other words, they were saying, how comes a sign isn't sent? We want a sign. We want a sign to show that you are a messenger. We want this mountain to go up in the air. We want the sky to fall down. Or we want, you know, water to gush forth. So again, they were doing istib'ad risalati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, we want to find some more examples. Now, you see, if a person understands how shirk is being tackled in this surah, it's just a powerful surah. This surah contains the sources, the roots of understanding how religions become deviated, yeah, and how people innovate inside their religions. So this is a very beautiful surah for this. Okay. فلولا إذ جاءهم بأسنا فلما نسوا ما ذكروا به فتحنا عليهم قل أرأيتم أتاكم عذاب الله وما نرسل المرسلين والذين كذبوا قل لا أقول لكم إني خزان وأنذر الذين ولا تطرد الذين وإذا جاءوك وكذلك نفصل الآيات قل إني نهيت أن أعبد قل إني على بينة وعنده مفاتح الغيب لا يعلم إلا هو وهو القاهر فوق عباده ثم ردوا إلى الله مولاهم الحق قل. I'm just trying to find some examples of وكذب به قومه الحق ولكل نبأ مستقر. So فتعلمون وذر الذين اتخذوا دينهم لعبا ولهوا وغرتهم الحياة الدنيا. leave, O Messenger of Allah, leave those people who have taken their religion as a mere sport, a game, lahwan, and a distraction, entertainment. وَغَرَّتُمُ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا, and the life of this world has deceived them. وَذَكِّرْ بِهِ أَن تُبْسَلَ, and he goes on. So this is what their religion was all about. It's basically just kind of like, you know, similar to a game, sport, or some sort of competition and distraction that they have. أَنَدْعُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُنَا وَلَا يَضُرُّنَا, so they were worshipping things that they believed would benefit them, like idols and statues and trees and so on. Okay, then the Ibrahim alayhi salam story comes into here. See, Ibrahim alayhi salam story actually is a good way of making them realize this is the true narrative of Ibrahim alayhi salam. This is where Ibrahim alayhi salam originally, his message comes from. And this is where your shirk is false. He actually fought against shirk, right? He fought and he, you know, spoke up against the evil that was happening in his community. So therefore, this clearly shows that Ibrahim alayhi salam's position was an anti-shirk position. So how can you attribute yourselves to Ibrahim alayhi salam? Doesn't even make sense. Yeah. Okay. Alright, so... Okay, so we don't really have time to go through all of this, but right, Ibrahim alayhi salam is clearly using logic to make them understand about how their shirk is wrong. I'm trying to find examples of the wrongs they were doing in the community. كَنَمَيْتًا وَكَذَلِكَ إِذْ جَاءَتْهُمْ دَارُ السَّوَاءِ يَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ جَمِيعًا وَكَذَلِكَ نُوَلِّي بَعْضَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Okay. وَجَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ مِمَّا ذَرَأَ مِنْ الْحَرْثِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ نَصِيبًا. They made for Allah مِمَّا ذَرَأَ, that which He created, مِنْ الْحَرْثِ, of the vegetation, وَالْأَنْعَامِ, and cattle, نَصِيبًا, they made a share. فَقَالُوا, they said, هَذَا لِلَّهِ, this share is for Allah, بِزَعْمِهِمْ, according to their own made up assumption. وَهَذَا لِشُرَكَائِنَا, and this, the rest of this is for our associates, the shirk that they're doing. So they had idols, let's say they have 10 idols, and they said, okay, Allah gets this much, and our 10 idols get this share. So we're going to worship Allah this much, and we're going to worship the idols this much. فَمَا كَانَ لِشُرَكَائِهِمْ فَلَا يَصِلُ إِلَى اللَّهِ, whatever they have attributed for their idols falsely will never reach Allah. وَمَا كَانَ لِلَّهِ فَهُوَ يَصِلُ إِلَى شُرَكَائِهِمْ, and that which is you do for Allah will definitely reach their shuraka. سَاءَ مَا يَحْكُمُونَ, how evil is that which they decide. وَكَذَلِكَ زَيِّنَ كَثِيرٍ مِنْ الْمُشْرِكِينَ قَتْلَ أَوْلَادِهِمْ, and likewise it has been made beautified for many of the mushriks, or he has made beautified for many of the mushriks, قَتْلَ أَوْلَادِهِمْ, their shuraka, sorry, their partners, the shuraka that they have attributed or have established, have beautified for the mushriks, قَتْلَ أَوْلَادِهِمْ, to kill their children. In other words, they justify killing their own children, the innocent girls. They justify this by saying, this is what our gods want. لِيُرْدُوهُمْ, to throw them, وَلِيَلْبِسُوا عَلَيْهِمْ, to confuse upon them their religion. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا فَعَلُوا, if Allah wished, they would never have done this. فَذَرْهُمْ وَمَا يَفْتَرُونَ, so Messenger of Allah, leave them and leave their lies that they attribute to Islam. So you can see, they began to distort the text, they began to kill the offspring, and all these kind of evil things came about. And this is a very good sort of like summary of the problems that they had. So when you read the Quran and you look back at this, you'll say, oh yeah, this is the main reasons why they had the issues that they had. These 8 reasons are the main issues that they had when it came to their shirk, when it came to their deviant ways, right? The shirk, personifying Allah, distorting Ibrahim alayhi salam's message, rejecting the hereafter, thinking the Prophet's message was far-fetched, the spreading of evil actions in the society, the innovation of corrupt practices, and leaving the ibadat. And you can actually look at this. He looks as though he's done this in a sequence. Starts off with shirk first of all, then shirk leads to giving Allah human features, and then it leads to distorting divine texts, and then it leads to rejecting the hereafter. And once you reject the hereafter, you can't imagine how the Prophet ﷺ is the messenger. You begin to spread evil actions in the community, innovate new evil practices, and leave ibadat. And this, I would say, this can also be seen in atheists as well. So atheism is a form of shirk, in a sense, according to some scholars. So therefore, this results in attributes they're supposed to give to Allah, they give to other things, nature and other things. Divine messages, they end up saying that, oh, these, you know, these prophets that came in the past were just, they were good people, and they weren't divine in any way. They were just, you know, revolutionists, and they had a message, and they had a policy and a mandate, and this was their mandate, and this is what their mandate really meant, and Jesus was just a revolutionist, and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a revolutionist, etc. They deny the hereafter because their science can't prove it. They begin to see the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as being something far-fetched, as in it's not really something which is good. At that time it was good, but today it's not good. And then they start to spread evil actions in the society around the world, globally. And then they invent their own innovated evil practices, and they leave ibadat, or they swap it with something else. Maybe, I mean, someone can even today maybe come up with something like that as well. So anyway, I'm going to leave you with that. So have a go at this. Let me know in the comments what you guys think. If you guys think that we should practice a bit more on this point number two. Or should we move on to the next thing next week, which is the definition of shirk and its examples in the Quran? Let me know, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair, guys, for watching this video. I really, appreciate you guys leaving me feedback. And I always look forward to it, actually. And inshallah, stay safe. These days, we're going through a lot of difficulty, especially with the coronavirus. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. And may Allah allow us to be able to do the khidmah of his deen in the best way possible. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakumullah khair, guys, for all of your support. Without your support, I wouldn't have been able to produce the videos that I've put up on my YouTube channel. And there is so much more that I really want to do. And without the support of you guys who are patrons, generously supporting this channel, I've been able to get myself a camera, which, as you guys can see, the quality of this camera, a mic system, software, I've been able to hire an editor. So what do I want to do? I want to make lots and lots and lots of more videos for beginners, for intermediate, advanced, in the subjects like Arabic and fiqh and hadith and tafsir and aqidah and all those other things as well. And for this to happen, again, this channel needs support. So if you guys want to become patrons and support this channel, then check out the link below. Also, if you do become patrons, you'll have access to videos that I don't put up on my normal YouTube channel. So check that out, inshallah. And there's most other perks as well that you guys can benefit from. And if you want to access this channel through social media, we've got Twitter, we've got Instagram, Facebook page, and other things as well that you can visit. So jazakumullah khair again, guys. Thank you very much for your support. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakumullah khair for watching this video. I hope to see all of you guys. If you guys are interested, please leave us feedback, get in contact with us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.